Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of Sports Talk 1996 on YouTube with me, Zach Barnett. And we're joined in by the hardest hidden linebacker for the Chargers, Stephen Cooper, other than Merriman, of course. How's it going, man?
Going good. Thanks for having me on. Appreciate it.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So let's get it rolling with what stood out about the Chargers to keep you around for 9 years, man. Like, that's a long time to stay with one team, especially a linebacker.
Well, the opportunity with the Chargers, coming in as a free agent in 2003, with Junior Seau just leaving, it was a great opportunity for me being a free agent, having the opportunity to make an NFL team coming from the University of Maine in a 1AA school. So to be there for 9 years, it's kind of hard to play for one organization, mm-hmm. no matter who you are. I'm in the NFL, but I think I worked hard. I think management and the coach just seen how much hard work I put in, and I was trying to be the best team player I could be, as well as a leader. And I think that's what kept me with the Chargers for 9 years.
Definitely. So scrolling it forward for the current Chargers, what does Justin Herbert need to prove to get that long-term contract with the Chargers? And the market's pretty high for quarterbacks at the moment, with Deshaun Watson getting that fully guaranteed deal, but I want to hear your take on it.
I think with Justin Herbert, he's came into the league with a lot of success early. The biggest thing is staying in the playoffs. Being with the Chargers myself for 9 years and just being around and knowing the history of the Chargers, Charger fans really want to win a Super Bowl. So like that, playing at a high level so early, it shows a lot of promise. But at the same time, I know as an individual, being a former player, he has to go out there and show it week in and week out, but he must stay healthy. That's the biggest thing. And at the same time, it's a team game, so he needs his wide receivers to stay healthy, his O-line, the running game got to stay consistent for him to be successful in order to be a great quarterback and to get that top-tier money like a Deshaun Watson. But I think Justin Herbert, being a young player, I know the franchise wants to build around him, but they got to do a better job of whatever it is of keeping guys healthy and at the same time just building the roster.
Definitely, man. So in free agency this year, they've been pretty quiet. So what exactly do you think they need to be a Super Bowl contender?
I think any NFL player that gets the opportunity to play professionally, they all deserve to belong there. The biggest thing is just building the locker room, the continuity and the togetherness of all these young men and grown men on coming together one play at a time, week in and week out, in order for them to be great. And that's just any NFL team, not just the Chargers. You got a bunch of men that make a lot of money, so you have some egos, you got some pride, but a lot of these individuals, you put that aside in order for the team to be successful. And that's the only way the Chargers are going to get it done, if they get all hands on deck for all 53 guys in that roster, and coaches including, the same thing with the people upstairs making decisions. It's a collective effort, and I know being a former Charger, I hope they do well in the near future, and we'll see what they have to bring.
Definitely. From the teams that you played on, do you see a player on the current team that can fill that role that one of the playmakers on those Chargers team that you played for, like Merriman? Do you see that in the current Chargers?
Keenan Allen's a guy that sticks out to me. He's a guy that shows up each and every week, whether it's a Sunday game, Monday, Thursday. As long as he's healthy, you know he's going to go out there, give his best effort, and he's going to demand double teams and or the best cornerback or safety to have to cover him, all depending on where he lines up. So guys like Keenan Allen, being in the league for so long, I know he's earned the respect of his teammates in the locker room. So I feel like if he's a vocal leader and he's out there day in and day out working with the guys that are coming in and or new faces, I think that will bring a lot of success for the San Diego Chargers. Excuse me, the LA Chargers. I can't help it. I got to say San Diego. Oh,
man. Definitely, man. And Eckler in the backfield, that's a key part too, keeping him.
Yes, no, Eckler's a great running back. He does it in the pass game. He does it in the run game. And also, you have to be able to block at that position. So for him to be a three-down back, that goes a long way with a lot of these NFL teams being two running back heavy. For him doing what he has to do is a testament of his hard work during the offseason. So I can understand why he's asking for opportunities to look into trades to kind of maximize his financial situation. But at the same time, I feel like hopefully the Chargers can work some things out with him to keep him there, because I think he's an asset to Herbert and the rest of the team, and also complements what Keenan Allen does at the wide receiver position. So as long as you can have a steady run game with a passing game and you have those type of three guys, I think you want to keep all three of those guys and try to build around them with O-linemen that will protect the quarterback at the same time open up post for Eckler.
Definitely, definitely. So, Stephen Cooper, this concludes our interview on Sports Talk 1996. And for all of us that are tuning in, I greatly appreciate you. And, Stephen, it was an honor to have you on today, sir.
I appreciate you. Good luck with your podcast and everything that you're doing with these interviews. Look forward to watching a lot of your YouTube with these other NFL athletes from the past and the present. And just keep doing what you're doing, man.